You know what time it is? It's predictions o'clock, everyone! I'm Chip from the Digital Grandstand, and here are the preview and predictions for the 2017 Formula One Malaysian Grand Prix. And it is a bittersweet moment, to be honest. On one hand, F1 goes to one of the better racetracks this weekend. On the other, it'll be the last time in the foreseeable future we go to Malaysia. I don't want to see this race drop from the calendar. Why? Shut up, you're crying. I should calm myself. Designed during the late 90s by F1's favorite architect Herman Tilke, the track near Kuala Lumpur is the original modern F1 circuit. It was the very first Tilke-drome, and contrary to the trend in recent times by Mr. Tilke, the Sepang International Circuit is a rather brilliant designed track. Seriously, the dreaded Sochi Autodrome, Yas Marina Circuit and Baku City Circuit are all designed by the same person that penciled in modern classics like the Intercity Istanbul Circuit, the Bahrain International and, yes, the Sepang International Circuit. Having first hosted a Formula One round in 1999, the racetrack has become a success story in Formula One, but after the race this Sunday, after 19 years, F1 will wave goodbye to this proud facility. Well, you might be asking, why? If the track is such a great success story with drivers and fans alike upset about it being dropped from the calendar, why there won't be a Malaysian Grand Prix next year? The reasons are all long and complex, but here's the problem in a nutshell. Malaysia is rather close to another country that hosts a Formula One race, Singapore. And with the night race attracting more fans thanks to its unique atmosphere, fewer and fewer fans attend the Malaysian round over the years, and fewer fans buying tickets means less revenue for the organizers and the local government. So the decision was made to drop F1 from their list of yearly events. So yeah, this will be the last F1 Malaysian Grand Prix. Bumps. If anything, this requires some special drinking rules. So this Sunday, take one sip for every team radio and every overtake, and two sips for any retirement. It's time to down your drink for every safety car and if it starts raining, and of course down all your drinks at hand when the race is over. We will miss you, Sepang. Before we move on to the predictions, here are two bits of news that popped up in the world of Formula One this week. Firstly, autocar maker Aston Martin will become the title sponsor for the Red Bull Racing F1 team starting from next year. This is very interesting, especially considering the engine rules in F1. The current regulations run until the 2020 season, then the formula will change. And if that new set of regs will prove appealing, some major engine manufacturers around the world might just enter F1 in 2021. Cosworth, Lamborghini, Audi, and yes, Aston Martin. And I'm having a boner just thinking about that. The second piece of news this week regards the lineup of Scuderia Toro Rosso for this weekend. Even though there were rumors of Sainz moving to Renault as soon as this Friday, it's the other driver of the team that will vacate his seat for this race. That's right, Red Bull Junior and reigning GP2 champion Pierre Gasly in Malaysia will replace Daniel Kvyat. Personally, I can't wait to see how Gasly compares to a proven quantity like Sainz. After all, it's a certainty that he will get his first full F1 season next year. As for Kvyat, well, I still think he will be on the grid next year with Toro Rosso. Not only because the junior program doesn't have a replacement for him, but he's also a powerful marketing asset for the drinks company in Russia. Okay. Those were the news, now for the predictions. In 10th place, Lance Stroll. It starts to feel like the Canadian is more and more a match to his experienced teammate. 9th place, Carlos Sainz. He's going away from Toro Rosso, that's a fact, and he will leave them as big of a chunk of points as he can this year. In P8 and 7, the Force Indias. Perez shouldn't have a problem keeping Ocon behind this time round. As long as they don't bump into each other, yet again, the Pink Panthers will score double points again this time round. 6th and 5th places, it's the Red Bulls. Daniel Ricciardo and Max Verstappen. Yes, Daniel won here last year and yes, he bested Max in a thrilling duel. This time though, I think the youngster will show the way at Red Bull. In 4th, Kimi Raikkonen. unless he gets an electric start like in Singapore, he might not be able to keep up with the Mercs and Vettel here. Opening up the podium in third place, Valtteri Bottas. He openly admitted he's after Vettel in the Drivers' Championship for that runner-up spot, and these two should provide a fairly exciting duel. But Vettel should just get the better of him and score a second place here. After the calamities in Singapore, he will get his elbows out and target the win. However, it won't be enough to get it. Lewis Hamilton will be the victor on Sunday. He comes to Malaysia knowing he has unfinished business on this track after his engine failure last year. It was lap 41, he was leading by a considerable margin, then the win was cruelly snatched from his grasp. And in my view, this retirement and his poor form in Japan cost him the title last year. Pole position as well for Hamilton this weekend on a track that will suit the Mercedes W08 to a T. Ferrari and Red Bull might get in a scrap of their own, but the prancing horse should be that bit better. In the midfield, I really do look forward for a race-long battle between the Force Indias, Williams, Sainz and even Hülkenberg. And there you have it, my predictions and preview for the final Malaysian Grand Prix. Thank you ever so much for watching. Don't forget the drinking rules. Leave a comment with your predictions, like and share this to your Formula 1 buddies. If you're new around here, please do remember to subscribe. I've been Chip from the Digital Grandstand. You can find me on Twitter at chip_DGS. And I'll chat to you again soon.